हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द क्वेश्चन कोड 15 जीपी 110230. सो व्हाट इज गिवन इन दिस क्वेश्चन दैट दिस इज एन इनिशियल लेंथ. ओके, दिस इज अ नेचुरल लेंथ एंड देयर आर टू ब्लॉक्स M1 एंड M2. ओके, देयर आर टू ब्लॉक्स M1 एंड M2 एंड देयर इज अ स्प्रिंग ऑफ स्प्रिंग कांस्टेंट K. नाउ व्हाट इज गिवन दैट दिस इज अ स्प्रिंग कांस्टेंट K, दिस इज थीटा, दीज आर टू ब्लॉक्स M1 एंड M2. M1 इज कनेक्टेड व्हाइल M2 इज फ्री. This is given. M2 is free to move. We have to find three parts in this. Suppose this is spring. Suppose at equilibrium we have to find the first part. At equilibrium we have to find the compression. So the first point that we have to find at here is at equilibrium. What should be the compression? So at equilibrium I know that F net should be equal to zero. Okay, F net should be equal to zero. So the downward force that they are exerting, which is equal to M1 plus M2 G sin theta, should be equal to Kx. So Kx is equal to M1 plus M2 G sin theta. And I can say X is equal to M1 plus M2 G sin theta by K. Now the second part, suppose I assume that this is equal to x0, okay? So this is x0, I am said that if spring is pushed 2 by km1 plus m2 by g sin theta, I have to find the position at which these two blocks will separate. So I can say if this is x0, this is 2x0, okay? However much it would have pushed it, that doesn't matter. We know that it would separate at natural length, okay? It would separate at natural length, no matter how far you have pushed or not. Okay, it would separate at natural length of spring. Because what will happen at natural length of spring? If you look at the natural length of spring, this is what happens here is that suppose this is at mean position now. Here F net is equal to zero, and I am pushing it by 2 by K here. So it will what will happen is after it comes to natural length, we can say that the acceleration of the block should be equal to g sin theta at natural length. The net F net due to spring, F spring would become equal to zero, and I can say F spring would become zero, and I can say that the acceleration of the block should become equal to g sin theta. Now I know the acceleration. I can say that acceleration on SHM comes out to be acceleration is equal to omega square x. So if I write x is equal to, if the position that at which the separation will take place, it comes out to be a by omega square, and we have to find the value of omega here. So we can say this is the spring mass system. Omega can be just simply written as k by M1 plus M2. So if I put here value, this is g sin theta, and I am putting the value of omega here, which comes out to be omega square, which comes out to be k upon M1 plus M2 g sin theta by k. So if you have to find the position, It is given with respect to the mean position, okay? So we can also say that from the natural length, the distance from natural length and mean position is this distance. So the answer would be same for both the parts, A and B, okay? So if you have to find numerically, I have even calculated numerically, okay? Now we have to find the C part. For the C part, I am asked the common speed of block when they separate. So we know that the position at this point of separation is x0, or natural length I can say, and amplitude is 2x0 because it is pushed by 2x0. So if I have to find value of velocity, I can put velocity is equal to omega under root of a square minus a square omega. A square can be put as 2x0. x can be put as x naught omega, it comes out to be root 3 omega x naught. Now omega we can put here is under root of k m1 plus m2, and x naught value we have calculated, it comes out to be m1 plus m2 g sin theta by k, m1 plus m2 g sin theta by k. So if you solve, you will get root 3 m1 plus m2 by k g sin theta. This is the velocity at separation point. Okay, this is the velocity of common velocity, common speed when they separate. So this was the final answer.